It's kind of shocking to know that it was here.
Alonze Thornton says his grandmother lives in the same building where this shocking video was broadcast on Facebook Live Tuesday.
This right here, he represents Trump.
Showing a white teenage victim with mental health issues being abused by four black individuals.
Actually hearing about it word of mouth that it was in the area and actually coming here today knowing that it was his. It's appalling.
The suspects face a slew of charges, including aggravated kidnapping, aggravated battery with a deadly weapon, and hate crime. The judge denied the suspects bond Friday and scolded them in open court, saying, "I'm wondering where was the sense of decency that each of you should have had."
I do want to say that.
Sorry, to the family.
I'm sorry this happened to the family.
One family member of the two female suspects, who are sisters, apologized outside court. Inside, the suspects showing no emotion, even when prosecutors described their alleged every move in open court. From suspect Jordan Hill picking up the victim at this McDonald's in a Chicago Northwest suburb on New Year's Eve, to Hill allegedly beating the victim before these cameras started rolling. Once they did, according to prosecutors, Hill even asked for ransom.
The defendant Hill communicates with the victim's mother and demands $300 ransom in exchange for getting her son back.
When a neighbor called police, that's when prosecutors say the victim got a window of time to escape.
Neighbors tell us that this is the house where the abuse happened. They also point out that on the same night, there was a separate fight. The blood from that fight still remains.
A tough neighborhood in a city that is no stranger to violence. And now, a call for justice for a teen who police say is still traumatized by the torture he endured.
As for the victim, I spoke to the family spokesperson, and he tells me that the victim is with his family and they're asking for privacy and prayers. Rosa Flores, CNN, Chicago.